positive signals from Beijing that it prefers to negotiate than retaliate against the U.S. in matters of trade, plus possible window dressing help lift markets across Asia. Philippine shares rising as well, with the benchmark index gaining 1.1% or 87 points to settle at 79.79. The local bourse up for a second week but fell short of posting a monthly gain.
Well, usually after ghost month is the market tries to rally a bit. So, and the charts are oversold now and just starting to rise, actually. Ghost month was really, this year was really quite a roller coaster. It's good that we were able to come back for the end of the month.
So this is the backdrop, but so that's why you go local fundamentally. We are a bit more positive now on the market. So the last time you had me, it was mid-August, and that was actually the low of this current correction. That was August 15. And we've turned more positive because we're seeing some strength in the stocks that we like. And some corrections have happened that have been meaningful.
In corporate stories, BPI issues the first ever Swiss franc denominated and negative yielding bonds out of the Philippines. The 100 million Swiss franc or 5.3 billion peso ASEAN green bond will have a final maturity date of September 24, 2021. China-linked stocks remain in the spotlight, especially companies that have been planning oil exploration in the disputed South China Sea. Philippine Ambassador to China Chito Santaromana says they're looking at lifting the moratorium on service contracts 57 Northwest Palawan and 59 Southwest Palawan, both awarded to Pinoc Exploration Corp. For SC57, China National Offshore Oil Company, or CNOOC, is the operator with a 51% stake. Santaromana confirms they're targeting a commercial deal as early as November. PNOC is not a listed firm.
I'm not very optimistic about really anything being signed there because of what one side will have to admit if there is any agreement signed. Let's say it's 60-40, then that means China will have to admit, oh, okay, you own part of it. But is that their stand? Isn't their stand known? No, this is ours. The same for the Philippines.
Another exploration company, Manny Pangilinan's PXP Energy, which is also looking to restart talks on joint exploration with CNOOC, is still waiting in the wings. Next week, we begin a brand new week and the month of September, starting with inflation data for August. The consensus, further easing from July's 2.4%. Hopefully, a piece of news that the market will cheer. Reporting for ANC, I'm Michelle Long.